piece of noteworthy information has come out reported by Naval News. The outlet has reported that BAE Systems has stated that the Hyper Velocity Projectile, or HVP, is being tested by the U.S. Navy. This disclosure came out at the Association of the U.S. Army, AUSA, 2024 conference. Viewers may note that BAE Systems was one of two contractors that developed railguns for the U.S. Navy. The HVP projectile is leveraged from BAE Systems' Electro-Magnetic Laboratory Railgun program, which was canceled after funding was cut in the U.S. Navy's fiscal year 2022 budget. In this video, Defense Updates reports on the testing of the hypervelocity projectile in U.S. Navy warships. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. Naval News stated that it has learned from Jim Miller, Vice President of Business Development at BAE Systems, Combat Mission Systems, that the U.S. Navy is currently conducting tests of the HVP with a capability fielded to destroyers that are at sea today. The outlet further noted that, as per another BAE spokesperson, the HVP successfully demonstrated effects on a various number of airborne threats in their tests at sea, which can help support the Navy's air defense requirements. The HVP was tested aboard USS Dewey in 2018 as part of a RIMPAC exercise to test the round against cruise missiles and other airborne targets. In 2022, the development of HVP was reportedly canceled according to U.S. Navy budget documents. According to BAE Systems, HVP is a next-generation, common, low-drag, guided projectile capable of executing multiple missions for a number of gun systems, such as the Navy 5-inch, Navy, Marine Corps, and Army 155mm systems, and future electromagnetic, or EM, railguns. The HVP's low-drag aerodynamic design enables high velocity, maneuverability, and decreased time to target without the need for a rocket motor. The idea of HVPs is to have projectiles capable of attaining speeds of Mach 3 using traditional propellant charges. This is around half the speed of prototype railguns, but significantly faster than traditional shells being currently used by the U.S. Navy. The major advantage is that, unlike electromagnetic railguns, which require totally new installation, the HVP can be fired from Mark 45 guns. Mark 45 guns are already present in Arleigh Burke-class destroyers and Ticonderoga-class cruisers. Apart from speed advantage, HVP rounds have a range of around 50 miles, outranging the current shells by a massive margin. The current traditional shells have a range of about 15 miles. With HVP, the Mark 45 guns could be a more potent anti-aircraft and anti-missile weapon. HVP has an unspecified seeker which allows it to engage airborne targets. Currently, the warships have Evolved Sea Sparrow Missile, or ESSM, and the Standard Series missiles, like SM-2, for anti-aircraft and anti-missile roles. These are very expensive and not cost-effective, especially when used against small drones or incoming missiles. Close-in systems like the Rolling Airframe Missile, or RAM, and Phalanx Close-in Weapon System, CIWS, are designed for the last line of defense against air and missile threats and have limited range. HVP-equipped Mark 45 guns will be able to aid these weapons in anti-aircraft and anti-missile roles. At around $85,000 per round, HVP is a much cheaper option compared to any of these weapons. It will increase the magazine depth of the warships, enhancing capabilities against large swarms of one-way attack drones or cruise missiles. In practical terms, HVP will add a lot of flexibility without having to make radical changes. The U.S. Navy's Fiscal Year 2024 budget lays out plans for the service's continued development and preliminary testing of fire control elements for the HVP. The speed also makes HVP a good weapon against fast-moving surface vessels and significantly improves surface warfare capabilities. This is an extremely important aspect since the U.S. Navy's internal analysis has come to the conclusion that agile missile boats could be a potential threat to large warships like Arleigh Burke-class destroyers and Ticonderoga-class cruisers when operating in littoral water. As per Jim Miller, as reported by Naval News, future upgrades include seeker modifications that will allow the sub-caliber round to hit moving targets at sea and over land. If the HVP program becomes a success, it will add significant muscle to the U.S. Navy surface ships, which is actually needed keeping in view the advancements being made by rivals. The revelation of these tests comes at a time when it's become evident that the U.S. Navy could struggle with air defense when facing a determined rival. William LaPlante, the Undersecretary of Defense for Acquisition and Sustainment at the Department of Defense, noted at a conference hosted by the Center for Strategic and International Studies that efforts to stop drones fired by Houthi militants in Yemen are relying on costly missiles fired from Navy destroyers or fighter jets. He said it's getting too expensive. For example, Standard Missile 2, a medium-range surface-to-air missile, can cost $2.1 million per shot. This issue gained further attention when the U.S. forces collaborated with Israel and other allies to intercept around 300 one-way attack UAVs and missiles launched by Iran and its partners towards Israel. On that occasion, several F-15E fighter jets firing air-to-air missiles, Patriot air defense batteries, and Aegis combat system-equipped warships worked in tandem with Israeli systems like Arrow, David Sling, and Iron Dome to thwart the onslaught, but that came at a very high price. It's clear that a lot is riding on the HVP.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.